Let's see if this is working. Oh, there we go. Alrighty, hold on. I was just trying to get into the room. Alrighty, here we are. Hey, Shantae. Hey, Ariel. Can you guys hear me okay? Ooh, what was that? Can you guys hear me? Hey, Shells. Hey, Nancy. Hi, Ann. Okay, you guys will probably hear an echo because I have, I'm actually watching the view as well. So I'm trying to see if I can hear myself. And there's maybe a 5 second delay from when I talk to when it actually goes on camera. So if I'm late on answering anything, just wait a second. Oh yeah, these are my favorite. These are some of my favorite flower days. Oh, Pixie, I forgot your name. Alright, so really quick, I guess I might as well just get started. I don't think I'm going to be on too long, but everybody's always asking how I make my flowers. There is nothing difficult about the way I make my flowers. Every single flower that I make them the exact same way. There's no special technique. There's nothing where you're going to spend hours creating them. While shaping tools make flowers look beautiful and realistic, I don't have time for that. When I make my flowers, I want to knock them out quick. I don't want to spend a whole lot of time making flowers. So it doesn't matter what type of dye you use, it's the exact same step. So I always use a pair of tweezers. These are reversible, reverse tweezers, but these have a straight point versus the curved ones. So to use these, you just squeeze them and it opens them. So this is all I use to make my flowers, pretty much. Hi, Scrappy Tate. So I already have some flowers cut out. So just really quickly, I have some old cards that I've made that'll show you each of the flowers. So for this cottage cuts one, this one is a retired die. I don't think you can find it anymore. I know I've searched for quite a few people and you just can't find it anywhere. I believe they retired this at least 6 months ago. So sadly, you can't find this one anymore. So for that one, and let me take this card out of the bag. And sorry for the crinkling. I made this card last year, and all of these cards I made last year or at least 2 years ago. And let me see if I can get in frame. Come on, delay. Here we go. It is this one. Where's the camera? This one over here. Okay, so it's this flower here. This is the Cottage Cuts one. And that's the largest flower that you can create with it. So then, and I'm just putting these away because knowing me, I might do something to them. So don't mind my crinkling. Ah, forget it. Put it off to the side. Yeah, I know you love this card, Shells. You know what? Let's just leave it in the corner so you guys can have some eye candy to look at. So that's this flower, which I'll go and I'll make at least one of every single flower. So for this one, oh, not even in view. Let me move it over. Hi, Crafty Grandma. So for this specific flower, I used, let's see, let me look at it. Did I use just one or two? I think I used two. Two of the large one, which you can use both of these. None of the shapes are identical, but they still work the same. So two of these, two of this middle one, and one of this one. So let's move that one out of the way, put this to the side. So for the Impression Obsession poinsettias, this is the large set. I have two die sets in here. If you guys all know me, or if you guys have been around for a while, you guys know that I believe in multiples, especially when it comes to flowers and greenery and leaves. I will have at least three or four of each die. If I can buy more, I will, but it's kind of like a gradual thing. I don't buy them all at once. But I think since I make so many flowers, I need multiples. So I have two sets of the large and I have two sets of the small. So for the large, let me take this card out. Again, this is another card that I made last year, and I think it's right here. Let me see. So here's the large one, and here are two of the smaller ones. And I also did these pillow boxes recently for design team project. So this one here uses all of, I believe, the small set. And then this one, I use the two smallest petals from the large set. And this design is similar to the Spellbinders, I believe. But yeah, the Impression Obsession is still available. These two are still available. They're not retired. And then, last, as far as dyes are concerned, we have one of my all-time favorites. This one I've used for years and years and years. This is the Judy's Bloom. This one also is not retired. So you can still find this one as well. And I have three sets on this here. So this die here, I recall, I know it's less than $10. And in, this one will give you one large, one of these small ones, and then one of these trio leaf sets. So I believe it's like around $9. I'll have to look. I remember when this one came out, I believe it was like $16, $17 for just this plate. The small poinsettia set, I know you can typically find it around $8, between $6, $7, $8, usually $8. And then for one set of the large, I think I've seen them around for, if you find them on sale, anywhere from $15 to $18 for a set for the large ones. So let me move this out of the way. And then one more that I'll make on camera. And who else is coming in? Actually, it's the same one. Okay. Another flower that I will make is going to be, oh, I should just show the box. It's easier if I just show the box. Is that one there. Now this one is a silhouette file, so it's not a die. Oh, 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 there we go. So this one is a silhouette file, not a die. And when we're done with the stream, I'll link which file is in the description box. Alrighty, so let's get these out of the way. Alright, let's start with, I already have them cut out. Let's start off with, I guess we could start off with the Cottage Cuts one. Let's move some of these out because I've already pre-cut to do some of them. Let's see, I need those dies. I usually have pre-cut. Yeah, I find it that while, because I have a Silhouette, I have an old Cricut. I don't use the cartridges. I think I have the Expression and the baby one. I don't have the newer ones. I don't really use it. And I use my Cameo sometimes. Like, I think to cut these flowers out is the most recent thing I've done. I don't use it very often either. I prefer dyes. I don't know what it is, but I prefer actual dyes over an electronic machine. Alrighty, so, like I said, all I use is tweezers. I don't use anything else. Hey, girl. Let's see, any flowers and letters, at least one flower cut on them. Well, for the flowers, I find that almost any shape works. You kind of just gotta go with what you like. I know I'm picky. If there's certain shapes that I don't like, I won't use them. But for all the flowers that I've done, I mean, granted, I have like the shape, but it's always, I've used different ones. All right, so let's start with this one. So yeah, you can do it a couple of different ways. Very simply, I'll just take my tweezers, put it in the center of the petal, and then simply just cup them up. And you can cup them up as much as you want. Eventually, granted, they will flatten out a little bit. You can just fluff them back up. But that's essentially all I do. And depending on what the size of the flower is, will be as if I kind of just go towards the middle or if I go towards the very bottom of the petal. It's kind of your own personal preference. Okay. So yeah, just simply cup the flowers up. You don't have to be neat about it. You don't have to be perfect. I just go around and do it really quickly. Am I still in camera frame? Yeah. And that's essentially all that it is to it. And typically when I create flowers, I'll have a bunch cut out so I can make a whole bunch. So granted, I do have a flower order that I have to make and I've delayed on it, but essentially I have to cut out. I usually spend a good, 3-4 hours cutting. Oh, the bracelet? AliExpress. It's like one of the few things I've actually bought from there. I think it was like $1. Yeah, I know, you gotta love the dyes. I think that is my ultimate love, is dyes. Probably above bling and metal. Dyes are number one. Bling will probably be number two. Then you got, I'll spend an entire, I know there's been one day where actually the man took the kids out to one of his work events. I chose to stay home. They were probably gone maybe, because they actually had to go to Santa Clara and we live in Tracy, so I'd say they were gone at least 7 hours. I die cut the entire time. I didn't create nothing. I just die cut flowers. Let's see, let me catch up. Hey, Connie. No problem. Thanks for stopping by and saying hi. And for me, tweezers work really well too because, of course, the claws. It gets difficult because you can pinch them without it. I know I've been able to do it when I don't have the long nails. I can pinch them up without tweezers, but it's just more convenient. Can you tell me where you get your tweezers? These are Sizzix. These are made by Sizzix. Let's see, I know Blitzy carries them, and they're about $8. If you buy them in a regular store, they're about $10. But yeah, these are made by Sizzix. You can either find them just under the Sizzix line or under the David Tutera line. Sorry, I'm just kind of catching up on chat. Oh yeah, these are my favorite tweezers ever, 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 ever. I have like 4 of them. And I probably need like 2 more because I leave them laying around everywhere. And these are really good, again, because of my nails. If I'm gluing things together, I'll use these to hold things together while I work on something else. All right, enough blabbering. Okay, so let's get some glue out. So let's use, you can use any glue actually if you want. I tend to always use the Art Glitter Glue. But I've been really liking this Nuvo adhesive, and this of course is thanks to Shantae, because she told me when they were on sale at scrapbook.com, so I had to go and get me some. But I do use that. I've been using this quite a bit, but I think this one will always be my go-to. Yes, Cindy, these are a lifesaver. Okay, let's see. Do I want a little mat? Oh, here we go. So I have one of these little mats. This came with a Sizzix old flower shaping kit when Susan, ooh, what's her name? Susan, the one that's with Elizabeth Craft Designs now. When she was with Sizzix, she had a flower toolkit. And actually, that was where these first came out. I have a pair that are green, that have a green handle. They came out with hers, and then they re-released them like a year and a half ago with David Turturro. But this little piece came out. So I just use this because a lot of these have holes in the center. So if you're adding a whole bunch of glue, it just keeps it from your workspace. Let's see, Scrapatina, if it doesn't have a dye, I feel like I didn't make it. Oh, I completely agree. I'm the same way. Majority of my projects are like 90% dyes. Okay, so we've got the big one, we've got two small ones, and then a small center. Okay. So I know that this art glitter glue always tends to be a little runny. Let me grab the other one. So I have two. And sorry if I keep reaching across. I'm grabbing stuff from my pegboard. I have shelves on my pegboard. So you're going to see my arms going across quite often. So usually, even when I'm gluing down, I'll even use my tweezers for that. So, and the same thing, all you have to do is offset your flowers. I mean, your each flower petal, offset it. Never lay it down in the exact same spot. And after you glue it together, you can always form and add more shaping to your flower. I know. I feel bad for always using it, but it's such a gorgeous flower. I can't help myself. Because every time I use it, people will ask me, where'd you get it? Where'd you get it? I can't find it anywhere. But yeah, it's gone. I'm so glad that I was able to get a second one. And I actually wanted two more, and I couldn't find them. Let me see, am I in order? Yeah. And you can make the flowers as full as you want. And I'm not in frame, am I? As far as how many flower petals you put down is entirely up to you. Obviously, the more you put down, the fuller the flower is going to be. And sometimes too many petals on a flower don't really work either. And I like really runny glue too when I'm making flowers because I can move the petals around a lot more. Hi, Jan. Oh, we got all kinds of people in today. Oh, my goodness. So, yeah, nothing fancy. Just making flowers because everybody always asks how I make my flowers. So, what's everybody up to? So, as you can see, this one is super full, nice and fluffy. Now I always make my flowers first and then I always add centers to them. Now you can do the option of punching a hole through and putting the stamens through. I don't care for those. I know a lot of people like them. I've bought some, but I don't like them. I punch holes, I put them through even through my favorite flowers, and I don't like any of them. Ooh, what games are you playing? So there's that one, and we'll add centers to all of these after we're done putting them together. So that's that one there. So let me put the tip back on here before it dries out and clogs. So next we'll go ahead and we'll do babysitting. Aw, 2-year-old. We'll make the poinsettia. Again, it's the exact same thing. I always use what? When I do poinsettias, I do two of the larger, the one that I'm using for the base, and typically two of the smaller ones, so usually use four. So again, same thing, since this is a long petal, I practically go all the way to the bottom. And the thing about flowers as well is you want to use sturdy cardstock. They shape better, they hold their shape better, the sturdier the cardstock. I always use 100 pound or 110. This red cardstock is 100 pound. It's the cherry red that's from Pop Tone by the French company, which I get from Paper and More. Oh, and I keep shaking. It's because I have my, because I'm streaming from my cell phone and I have it plugged into my computer to make sure it doesn't die on me. So yeah, again, on this one, I practically go the entire way down and cut them up. Oh yeah, I agree. You can never have too many flower dies. I'm always looking for flower dies. Because I put flowers, unless it's a masculine card, you will have a flower on my card. I can't do a card without flowers. At least if it's a feminine one, that's just my thing. Whether it's paper flower or it's a metal flower, it's going to have a flower on it. You have so many project shelves. I know, I still have to do our challenge card. I know I'm bad, I'm behind. I keep saying that I'm going to do it and I haven't done it. Are you still doing the backyard, Shelly? So yeah, obviously right now because I'm streaming and I'm trying to read the chat as I'm doing this, I'm going slower, but typically, hey Angela, typically to make one of these flowers, I mean, it takes less than a minute. It's really, really quick. And that's actually gluing it, cupping everything and gluing everything all together. It's really quick. Yes, yes, yes. I'll get to the card. I promise. I promise. I did die cut the butterfly. At least I got that done. So be proud of me for that because that's more than I've done for our challenge in maybe what? What has it been since we did our last challenge card? Like 6 months? Nope. Hold that down. Offset it center. And of course, everything's harder to do when you're live. I know, I'm terrible. And I use a lot of glue, people. I mean, I use a lot of glue. I am not shy when it comes to glue. Because I do not like my stuff falling apart. That is my one pet peeve, is if I get something and I have to re-glue it. I know adhesives in different, from the different states because of the humidity and all that stuff, it's difficult. So that's why I always just slap on a ton of adhesive. Because I don't want someone who gets something from me to have to glue it back together. That's just my own thing. Alrighty. So, and obviously when you're done, you can fluff them up even more. So there's that one. And these are all red because I actually had a custom order. I have to make a bunch of these, and as well as a lot of the Cherry Lynn. And they want them in this red. So that's why I cut all of these for the live in red. So that's that flower. So yeah, so when a lot of people say, oh, I can't make flowers, yes, you can. I don't do the shaping. Like, who's someone that does gorgeous flowers? Archana, she does the most gorgeous flowers that it's just like, wow. But again, I don't have the patience when it comes to doing all of that. Taking all the time to use the shaping tools and all of that stuff, that's not for me. This is my easy way, and it works for me. It's quick, it's easy, and there's no special technique. And always the same thing is the center of the flower is what, to me, is one of the things that really makes the flowers pop. I always use bling and I always use metal. That is my thing. I always put some sort of metal center on my flowers. I mean, occasionally I'll do just bling. Like on the poinsettias, I'll do just bling, but I do like three. Which we will add to these as well. And do we want to? Well, let's see, maybe. And again, like I said, your flower will always look different depending on how many layers you put on it. If you put just four, you have one look, you add a fifth layer, you know, a fifth smaller one, it changes the look of the flower. Similar, but always changes the look. No, I never spritz with water. Exactly. I don't have the patience to wait. To me, the paper gets flimsy. So yeah, I never, ever, 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 ever use water. I did buy the Heartfelt Creations. Hi, Christina. I remembered your name. I think it's in my brain now. I did buy the shaping mold and I haven't used it yet because I have to spritz it. I don't want to wait for it to dry. And I think that's one of the reasons why I haven't used it yet. Let's use one that actually has the bottom. So yeah, just making some flowers, Christina. I always get asked in all of my videos, how do you make your flowers? Show me. So, and I have done start to finishes on cards where I put the flowers together. But sometimes people don't want to go back and watch the entire tutorial, so I figured I'd just do some flowers. Yeah, mine's unopened as well. I think the only thing I did was show it on the haul that I did, and that was it. It's the concept is nice, but it's, again, it's the spritzing with water. So what's everybody up to? You guys crafting? I know Shelly says she was cleaning. And I already forgot what Abril said she was doing. Sorry, girl. I forgot. See, so like here, you just have the three. You have the two large and one small. But let's add another one. Obviously, the more you add, the sturdier it is. Come on, get the pin back in there. Let's move it off, offset it, and center. Am I still in frame? No, not really. Okay. Alrighty, so that's that for that. Let's bring out some bling so we can do the centers. Tea bags. Oh, nice. Winter craft fairs. I haven't done any craft fairs in forever. That's why I have like a whole stockpile of cards, because I'm too lazy to open a store. Okay, let's see. We are doing, let's do my favorite. There's these ones too. And I guess we can, oh, what color bling was I supposed to put in the center of these? Ooh, I forgot. We'll do clear. We will do clear. Ooh, nice. Hey, Ladybug. And I forgot your name again. It's been a while. I forgot your name, Ladybug. I'm sorry. Okay, so for large flowers like these, depending on if I'm doing these little stamens, which you guys are all familiar with, these always use SS16s. If I just do, like if I just plan on doing one large one in the center, I usually go with Vanessa's 30. So here's what Vanessa's 30 looks like. And yes, I use my nail as a scoop. That's what Vanessa's 30 looks like. Let's see. Let's measure it, see if we can get. Nope, I don't want that ruler. I need to stop shaking my desk. It's what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's about 7 millimeters, an SS30. And then also for the larger flowers, if I'm doing a poinsettia, and it's only if I'm doing a poinsettia, I'll do 3, like you see on this pillow box. And those are what? I think those are SS16s as well. The size of your, whether it's a rhinestone or a pearl, is entirely up to you. But those are, for flowers, my most common sizes are SS16. Well, I could use this big SS34. We'll take that one out. Or if I do 3 in the center, let's take out SS12 too. Yes, this is my bloom hoard. I have like 3 of these trays. Granted, they're not all full because I have a mixed matched. But if I was to put all of them that had bling in them, I'd probably have 2 of these full. This is probably one of my favorite crafty tools as well. Crystal Katana. I live by this stick. I love this thing. And do I have my katana match? Ooh, don't shake. I keep shaking my desk. Sorry. Okay. Forget the mat. Oh, here it is. So here's the little mat. This thing is not necessary. It just makes it easier to flip things over. Alrighty, so for this one, we're going to use one of these little stamens because I put these on all my flowers. Anytime I glue any metal down, I will always use glossy accents. Always, always, always. I don't use any other glue. Oh, okay. Not in grain. There we go. And I'm not shy, I use a ton of it. Nope, not that one. That's not the one with the pin. This one is. Okay. Oh, did I just, nope, that's glue. Alrighty. Any questions while I'm gluing? Is this almost out? Alrighty, and I gotta stand up to look over to put this in. So if my head gets in the way, sorry. Nope. And the thing you have to remember with glossy accents is you gotta be patient with it. It takes a while to dry. Sorry, taking it out of frame real quick. Because I really need to push this down. Okay. Alrighty, let's see. Sorry, just making the screen bigger on my computer for this video so I can see a little bit better. Alrighty. So yeah, there's that one. Then for this one, I guess we can do the 3 rhinestones. This one, what do we want to put on it? We want to put one of these. And all of these are just, these are bead caps. Everybody asks what my flower centers are. They're all bead caps. But I don't really do bead work, so I use them on my flowers. And I'm just shaping them and molding them to cut them up a little bit more. These are bead caps. Is it Lasonia or Lasagna? Is it one or two? But yeah, they're bead caps. You can find them everywhere. Okay, Lasonia. All right, cool. Because I know everybody pronounces their name differently, so I don't want to keep pronouncing it wrong. Actually, no, we want a little more. And while I do put a lot of glossy accents on it, just be careful because obviously with glossy accents, it dries shiny. They don't have the matte accents anymore, which would be ideal. Push that down. See, and the glue's even oozing out of the center. Alrighty, so for this one, well, actually, this one I need is just 20. All right, cool. I said it right the first time. I know. I wish they would bring it back as well. Wait, do I want an SS20 in the center or is that an SS30? Hold on, I gotta pull it out to see. SS20 works. Okay. We'll put an SS20 in the center. Oh, I have to make the white flower too. I just forgot about the white one. I think this glossy accents is almost empty. So, question for you guys. So for the next live stream, because you guys know I kind of come on randomly. I've also been getting a lot of questions about, they want tutorial on how I make all my metal embellishments. And that's just one of those things that I just haven't done in a while. So would you guys want to see that? Or let's see, what's another one? People have asked for me to just do a card live. Like pick one of the cards I've already made and kind of just do a start to finish on those live. So what do you guys think? Moving it around. Thank you, Avril. All right, so this one is gonna have an SS16. And I don't even know why I brought this mat out. Usually when I use a lot of bling and I drop it on the mat is when I'll use it, because this is good for flipping the rhinestones over. Because on this one, I can tap my nails on top of the mat and it'll flip the rhinestones over. There we go. This one will do 3. And I'm surprised my kids have been quiet. Actually, you know what? This is paper to paper. I don't need glossy accents. I only use glossy accents when I'm doing metal. If it's not, then I'll use art glitter glue, because even if I put a ton down and it oozes out, it dries clear, so, and it doesn't dry shiny, so it works. So let's do SS16 for the center as well. Yeah, bead caps can be hard to find. I buy them through a wholesale distributor, so I have to buy mass quantities of them. So it's not something that I can just direct you to, like, oh, go to Michael's or... But try jewelry stores. A lot of online stores, jewelry stores that have lots of beads, they'll carry lots of bead caps and lots of different designs. So yeah, as you can see, a whole bunch of glue oozing out. You won't be able to see it when it dries. So let's move these to the side and we'll make the white flower. So yeah, so these ones kind of lost their shape And because the center is still drying, I'm not really going to move it around too much. But after that, you can just reform it. So there's that one with the center. And here's this one, of course, my favorite. Hey, Cherie, I sent your blank package out. Hey, Scottish Crafter. And this one, it looks funny because the glue's still wet, but that's the center of it. So yeah, those are the three that I cut out as far as the flowers. So this is the one that we're gonna make next, because I know I showed this box when I first started, so you can see it. This is the one that's the SVG file. And like I said, once I post the stream, when it's done, I'll link that one in the Silhouette store. Hi, baby. You want to say hi? Over here. Where's your hands? Hi. Wave your hands. My little one's saying hi. All right.
Can I have my candy?
You want some candy?
Yes. I want the candy.
All right, you need to brush your teeth after this because you know the gummies are bad for your teeth. Right here. One.
Oh, just one.
I didn't say just one. Hold on. Here. Two. Three.
Oh, I want a four.
You want four? All right, fine. This is my candy. Come on.
Thank you.
He came to steal these. These are my favorite candy in the whole wide world, and he came to steal them.
These are so good.
Because I told them if they behaved and they were quiet, I'd give them some when I was done. I did. I gave him candy, Shelly. Even though it's mine and my favorite, I shared, okay? Okay. Oh, yeah, so that flower. So let's bust out the leaves for those. Oh, yeah, they're never ending. Usually I'm having to get up and, because I'm upstairs and they're downstairs, so usually I have to get up, walk out to the hallway, shout down the stairs, tell them to be quiet or to tell them to stop fighting. Oh, so here are two. Let's see. There's that one. Where's the other size? There's a third size. Oh, right here. So the same flower SVG file. The one that I just had is the small one here. Let me bring it back out. So this is the smaller one of the ones I cut out. Then I adjusted the size. And these I flattened out. I gotta fluff them back up. But here's what it looks like larger. And here is the largest size that I have. So yeah, you have a couple of different sizes. And the good thing about SVG files is you usually get about 3 to 4 different petal sizes within the original SVG. And then you can resize them to whatever you want. Oop, I'm not even in frame that well. Hold on. Let me put those back out. Over here. Here's my camera. Is it right here? Yeah, so we're gonna make the smaller ones. Okay, so those, again, it's 4. I always do 4 large, 4 small. That's typically my standard. So yeah, if you don't wanna go out and buy dies and you do electronic cutter, grab the electronic files. Yeah, I rarely use mine. It's the same thing. I try to use it more. So again, same thing. This is a longer petal, so go all the way to the bottom and cup them up. And I don't care that it wrinkles because I don't wet the cardstock. It will wrinkle the paper. I don't care. Not an issue for me. Thank you. I know my nails are kind of, they're a topic on my channel. You either love them or you hate them. So a lot of times when you don't see videos from me for like 2 weeks, Well, it could either be that I'm just not in the crafty mood. Like, I haven't posted a project since my last design team project because I haven't felt like crafting. Usually, every couple of months, I cut off my nails completely. Because usually, the length of them are mine. I just have them covered with the acrylic and the gel powder. But, like, a month ago, it was a month and a half ago. I cut them completely off. I cut down my own nails and gave them a breather because I give them breaks. And then I started the process again, and I had to put on tips because I hate the acrylic, like the actual tips, but I had to put them on because I won't do the short nails. Okay, let's see. Got one more small one. Ten, I will say, is a good age. They can get stuff for themselves. They don't really, well, no, they still bug you. Oh, I left you next door to me. Oh, your grandkids are right next to you? Nice, Cindy. Oh, nope, let's not put that one because then, it's sticking to me. So who likes to make their own flowers versus buying them? Hold on, I gotta bring it back real quick. There we go, back in frame, sorry. Ooh, is it moving around? I think it's moving around on me. Oh no, I didn't cut that flower, that's why. You know what? Flip that one over. Where's another pair of tweezers? I didn't cut this petal up. See, multiple tweezers come in handy. Prima does have really pretty flowers, but I'm always so stubborn that I don't I won't pay for flowers if I can make them myself. Is the cameo still giving you issues? I tend to avoid designing on the cameo. Oh, nope, charms more. It is a bit of a pain. Once you get the hang of making your own flowers, it gets really easy. Like, the only reason I'm fidgeting so much and taking so long is because I'm on camera. But I usually can sit down and do these while I'm watching TV and not really pay attention to it. Let's see. I'm kind of off. Yes. Having a good stash of flowers is nice. I always have a whole bunch cut out. All right, so let's put one of these in the center as well. Because, yeah, I'll sit for an entire day and just make flowers. Oop, that's kind of a lot. Or if not, like I said, I do die cut a whole bunch, and I usually have a good stash die cut out already. Because I don't craft every day and I don't have time to do a project, sometimes I'll just make a couple of flowers, even if that's all I can do. Yeah, that is true. Because a lot of the flowers that I've seen, it's the same thing. I'll see them and I'm like, I can make that. I mean, granted, it might not look exactly the same, but I actually like my flowers better than theirs. And that's one of the reasons, too, that I will buy the designer paper. Because, like, if you guys know, I'm not that big into paper, aside from colored cardstock. I'm not into, really, the pattern papers. But I'll just buy the paper stacks, like the 6x6s or the 4x6s, and I'll make my own out of the paper pad. Because that's essentially what they do. Yes, it is a good thing to kind of just do... I know I'm taking these to I've assembled flowers at my son's jujitsu because he's there for an hour. I'll sit in the waiting room and I'll just glue flowers together. Let's see. That's a 16. So yeah, I do have to make a bunch. I think I have to make, I think like 50 of these. No, wait, hold on. It's packs of six. No, it's 48. All right, I do 48 of this one. I have to do like 25 of this one. And this one, I think I'm doing almost 100. Hi, Denise. So yeah, I got quite a few flowers to make. So even the water parks. You know what? I guess we can do some of the smaller ones. I guess I can just make them. Any questions? You guys want to see the dies again for those of you that came later? Or the cards that I showed for the samples? Oh, this is this lady I've done things for her probably for the past 10 years. I met her at a craft fair. She started buying my cards at a craft fair. And eventually she just, you know, she just emails me and tells me, hey, I need this many, this color. I saw it on one of your projects. And she'll just place an order. And she doesn't really care. Since she knew I didn't have them made, I probably will give them, you know, maybe in the next 2 weeks or so. But usually she doesn't care. She's like, if you need a month, take a month. So I've known her for a very long time. But usually if someone does, if it's someone that I haven't had as a customer for a long time, if they order something, I try to do it within a week, if not 2 weeks. Because again, I don't craft during the weekdays. I craft on the weekends. I mean, occasionally, like I said, I might make a few flowers here and there. But thank you, Denise. What's the yes please for, Cindy? Oh, show the cards or show the dice? I already forgot the question that I had asked. So we got two large, two small. Love this size. Oh, both? Okay. Alrighty, so, and what I'll do too is, like I said, after I end the stream, in the description box, I'll actually link the videos to the cards in case you're interested of other stuff that I put on it, because I know that's another question I'll get to, is what I used on those cards, because they're old. I know these ones I didn't even show. So this one, let's see. You know what? The glare might not be bad. Like, here is the Judy's Bloom. This card I know I did in 2015. And that's this flower here. So that's the card. And this same one, like I said, this one, these are flattened out. But this one is the same flower as well. The only difference with this one is I folded it in the middle like I did all of these other ones, but then I took the sides and I folded them the opposite way. And do I have one cut out so I can show you? That's another option that you can do with flowers. I just think it adds a little bit more time. So for that one, to give it the wavy look, as you see it, where am I? Like that one. Again, fold it up in the middle, just like I did all of the others. And then move your tweezer to the edge of the petal. And you're going to fold it down. So hold the petal and then turn it in to the right. So you're basically putting, it's basically mountain valley. So you have a valley in the center and a mountain on the edge. Then go to the other side as well. And I flip it over because I don't like turning to my left really, but. So yeah, but this one takes a little bit longer because you have to readjust it. Once you fold it down, you got to adjust your valley again. So it gives you that little wave. Can you see that?
I can see it.
You can see it, baby? So yeah, that's the only difference is you're just folding it another way.
Gotcha.
But it's the same flower. So again, here is that one, but in white, because I know I showed it in black. But again, that's the Judy's Bloom, and that uses a different flower center.
Can I use
again?
Can I have chips?
Chips? You just had candy, baby.
But what?
What, do you want Doritos?
Yes.
Hey, Dorinda.
Who's Dorinda?
She's right here. Dorinda's right here. She's in chat saying hi. So yeah, those are the different, it's the exact same flower, and it looks a little bit different just based on how you shape it. And also, if you use the shaping styluses, you get a different look altogether. Again, I don't use the shaping. Hi, Henrietta. All right, you can have a few. Tell your brother to give you some. Not a lot. A little handful. You shouldn't be eating chips after you had candy. That's too much junk.
No, it's not.
And you're lucky that I'm streaming. That's the only reason why I'm letting you have it. Alrighty, so the other flowers. Here is a couple examples. Oh, the die. Let me show you the die before I move on to the next one. And where's the Judy's Bloom? Hold on, looking for the die. I just had it. Poinsettia, poinsettia. That one. Where's my Judy's Bloom? Oh, there it is. It's next to me. So again, that flower was this die here. Again, this one's not, it's not an expensive die for the most part. Again, I have three die sets in here. So if you buy this die set, you'll get one of these leaves, one of these large petals, and one of these small ones. That is the one set, and I know it's under $10. You should be able to. I don't really shop at Hobby Lobby because it's like 20 miles from me and I'm too lazy to drive that far when it goes to just a crafting store. So I usually make it to Hobby Lobby like maybe once every 2 years. But I think they still do. I know Michael still does and so does Joanne's. So yeah, again, this die is going to be under $10, I think. Oh wait, no, I have to look. You know what? I have my computer open. Let me look. Let me look right now while we're on the, while we're on here. And you're gonna hear a lot of click, 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 click because my nails, so if you don't like it, sorry. But it is what it is. All right, come on. Are you coming up? Come on. Here. Well, let's look for it by part number C184. Really? Come on. Judy. Oh, maybe it doesn't like it because I'm typing in caps. I'm not looking at chat, people, so if you guys are asking me something, I don't know. Oh, wait, no, I think that die is 14. Darn it, Judy. Is it, did they take it off their site? I'm trying to look at Dies R Us since it's the easiest place for me to find it. And now it's not pulling it up when I search for it. I wonder if they should still have it though. It's blog, let me look at the blog. Bop, bop, bop. Yes, everybody, subscribe to each other. Lots of crafty support here. Gotta spread the love on YouTube. All right, I'm trying to look on my blog real quick. Sorry, guys. But I will link it all when it's done. So let's see. We have Cherry Lynn, Judy's Blue, where is my description? Oop, this one right here. I used it on this project. Let's view it. Boom, there it is. Is it still there? Oh, they don't have it in the store anymore. But yeah, I'm thinking it's not $10. I'm thinking it's $15. I know the other ones are a little bit less expensive, but in my opinion, for as much as I use them, they're totally worth it. Yeah, I see them, like eBay has it for $12, Walmart has it for $12, Overstock, a little under $14, Scrapbook, is it scrapbook.com? $12.99, oh no, that's Scrapbooking Warehouse. But yeah, you're looking at, I'd say at least $13 for this die. Alright, let's go over the other ones again, kind of just doing a brief overview. Again, so this one that we made, the Impression Obsession large point setup, that's that one here. Am I still in view? Yes. So that one is using the two larger petals. This one from the same set, I'm using the smaller one and the middle, because again, you get three sizes. So this uses the smaller and then the middle size. And this big one uses the larger and the middle size. So that's those. And I didn't make any of the poinsettias with the small. But where's the pillow box? That little pillow box I just had right here. Here's what they look like. These are the three sizes from the small set. These are great little fillers, especially for those who are smaller card makers. Because for me, I prefer the larger flowers. So this is the three from the smaller set. So that die, again, here's the large set. And again, I have two on here. You'll get one of this size, one of this size, and one of that size. So those are the three. And then for the smaller one, again, I have two sets in here. Here is the larger size from the small set. Then, oop, this one's upside down. Oh, here we go. You have that one. And then the little tiny one. And with this one, you do have to remember, because the petals in the center are really, really thin, use heavier cardstock. And be sure to be careful when you're pulling it out. I don't know how many times I've ripped the petals right here at the smaller, the connecting point. These are not discontinued. No. These two, as well as the Cherry Lynn one, the one I just showed. These you can find anywhere. Again, this one, I think regular price is about $18 to $20. You can usually find it on sale for about $15. The smaller one is about $10, and usually you find it on sale anywhere from $6 to $8. When I was looking at that, I couldn't find it. It was on Dies R Us. That's usually, since I'm on the design team, it's easier for me to just access them really quickly since I'm always searching. They just discontinued it from the store. I do know that if some of you guys are subscribed to Cherry Lynn, they're doing some rebranding. They're changing their name. So I don't know what's going to happen with a lot of their stuff. I don't know if they're retiring old dies or if they're changing the names. I'm not exactly sure. But that Judy's Bloom, this one is a really old die. So I'm not exactly sure. So if this is one you want, you might want to look for it in case they, in their rebranding, they do discontinue it. I would say it's just might as well get it instead of figuring out later. But yeah, these two are not. These are Impression Obsession. And then the last, this is the one that is retired. Sadly, you can't find this anywhere. I've spent months looking for these for friends. I know for my friend Julie, the paper bag lady, I've looked for it for Shantae. I've looked for it for so many people, and I've been looking for months and months and months, and I haven't found it anywhere. And I know SMS, I had found it there. So if you're looking, it'll pop up there, but they don't have it, so don't buy it. Because I sent my friend Julie there thinking that they had it in stock. She bought it, and she, you know, they take forever to ship, first of all. And they shipped her other items like 6 weeks later, and they told her that that 3D flower number 7 was back ordered, but it's been discontinued, so you're not going to get it. So if you see it there, don't buy it, because you're not going to get it. It's been gone for months. At least the last 6 months, I haven't been able to find it anywhere. Ooh, where's my glue? There it is. So yeah, that's the one that's retired, sadly. That's a gorgeous flower. And as you can see on this card, that is what it looks like in white. So there's that one. And this one is actually a little bit fuller than the one I created on this one. So this one looks fuller. But it's the same flower. So you can see them side by side. They have the same similar shape, but they're slightly different because this one has more petals on it than this one. The poinsettia one, you should be able to find anywhere. You can just search for the Impression Obsession. So yeah, those aren't discontinued. You can go directly to the Impression Obsession site. I believe Simon Says Stamp has them, but I don't recommend Simon Says Stamp. I've never bought from them, and I don't think I ever will. But I think I saw them there. Dizeres has it. What was the last place that I saw it? There was another store. I can't think of it. Thank you, Cindy. But yeah, you should be able to find that one anywhere. Just search for that one. That one shouldn't be a problem. And I don't have any cut out, but I will show you my other favorite poinsettias. Because, and I'll probably do another separate video on these because I got the stamps. There's stamps that go with them. But while we are at it, where is that poinsettia? It is So the different flowers. So these ones you can still find. Now, I will tell you, these are not cheap. These are expensive. Especially if you're buying the Sue Wilson. This is the classic one. They do have a poinsettia editions that will give you some of this one and some of this one. But again, these are not cheap at all. I do know that the off-branded China company, I have seen them on their site. I don't personally buy from there, but that's just my thing. But if it's something you want and you don't want to pay, you can always search for it there. But yeah, these are not cheap. These are expensive dyes, but to me, they're well worth it. They do have coordinating stamps. And like I said, I probably will do, I did a dye feature on these Sue Wilson poinsettias last year, but I will probably do another one, an updated one, because I did get some stamps to go with it, and in that dye feature series, I didn't show any of the stamps that are coordinating with this one, because the original series has 4 different poinsettias. I showed 3 of them in that video. I did end up getting the 4th one, which is the mosaic, but that one's retired, so I'm not going to bother showing that one. I don't necessarily have one specifically for it. I did do a video, I would say maybe about 5 months ago, where I showed the container, the storage. Because I store mine the way Jennifer McGuire does. I have the DVD sleeves, or the larger ones, depending on the different sizes. I don't buy the Avriel brands. The only Avriel brand that I buy is the extra large one, because I haven't found generic ones of that yet. But if I was to find generic ones, I'll no longer buy the Avriel. But these are just regular DVD sleeves. Don't buy the Avriel. Those are ridiculously expensive. I've gotten these on Amazon, eBay, anywhere you can find them. The magnets are just the magnetic vent covers. And those you can buy at Home Depot or Lowe's, any of your hardware stores. And I just cut them down to size. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I don't buy the crafting magnet sheets or anything like that. Yeah, that's where I got the idea from. And I did a video on that one, but I didn't list specifically everything that I used. You do have larger pockets for my large dies. Like for my A4 size dies, I have these large ones. And these are just little snap closure envelopes. I bought these off of Amazon. These are for my really, really large dies because I have 4 different sizes. Oh yeah, but back to these flowers. So that's the poinsettia that one makes. So yeah, it's really simple. It's a different shape, but I like the different look. So that's that poinsettia. It's these 2 dies right here. And that's what it looks like with a smaller one right there. So it's the same flower here in the corner. And then here's a smaller version of it. Thank you, Laurel. Again, this is an old card. This is one of my Christmas cards from last year. Yeah, those are what these poinsettias look like. But yeah, there's a ton of different flower dies. I do have a bunch, as you guys can see from most of my cards. Like, for those of you that like the smaller flowers, this is the very last card that I did. Those are the poppy, the Sue Wilson poppy dies are a little bit smaller. So that's another flower. And again, all of the flowers, I shape the exact same way. Just cup them in the center, fold them up. That is it. I don't do anything else to them. I do occasionally use dye ink to color them, but as far as shaping, it's the same thing. Just cup them up. So there's really not much to it. And for the centers, you can use whatever you want. You can use the metal like I use it, or you can use bling, you can use pearls. You can use, like Shantae was mentioning in her video earlier, prills. Those are the little centers that Heartfelt Creations uses a lot on their flowers. You can use the regular flower stamens. So the centers are completely up to you, and whatever center you use is what's going to change the look of your flower. So yeah, that kind of about sums it up. Any other questions? Ooh, and I keep shaking the desk. Yeah, Avril has been here from the beginning. She's been quiet. But she's been here for a bit. So yeah, that's kind of it as far as flowers. It's kind of like I try to use a different flower on each card, but sometimes I've made a whole bunch and I just tend to use them. Oh, where did you get the ninja tool? Because you can pick that up at Michael's and you can use a coupon. Yeah, like when I bought this, I bought this regular price when it first came out. I paid $30 for this thing, but they have them at Michael's. So Michael's, they have them for $24 because you get the stick and the case. And you can use a coupon. So if you use a 50% off coupon, you can get it for $12. Yeah, no, return it. I would say when you get it, return it and then go to Michael's and use a coupon. It's going to be in the jewelry section where I know at least in the 3 that I've seen, they have them in where they have, what is the bling? The expensive bling. It's the Crystal Katana. It's this thing. It's my favorite thing ever. So yeah, well, before you return it, check your Michaels, because I know there have been a few people who haven't been able to find them at Michaels, but they do have them. So it's where they have, oh my God, the Swarovskis. You know the area by the beads and the Swarovskis that Michaels has? I've seen them at the bottom shelves by the Swarovskis. So yeah, use a coupon. Use a coupon. I bought a second one to have a coupon. You can pick up gems. You can pick up paper, small paper pieces. I've been able to pick up metal with it. It all depends on the force that you press down with it. Because this is a wax tip. And this thing should last you forever. I mean, they say that you should be able to do like 300,000 gem pickups with this thing. But even when this dies out, this is a barrel that you untwist and it comes out and you can replace it. And this replacement, I think, is like $10. I mean, but with the coupon at Michael's, use a 50 or 60% off coupon, get it for $10 to $12. But yeah, this is my favorite thing ever. Because I know with a lot of the other pickup tools, you pick it up and then you have to have something else to push the rhinestone down because it gets stuck to the center. It gets stuck to the tip. And the same thing with it is a lot of them leave residue behind. They leave residue behind on the bling. If you're using acrylic bling, you can't really tell too much. But if you're using like Swarovskis or Czech crystals or glass like I use, you see the residue left behind, so I have to wipe it off. But yeah, this is the best thing ever. You barely have to tap on the rhinestone. You pick it up and you set it down on your little bead of glue. It releases it on its own. You don't have to use like the quick sticks and the other tools where you have to pick it up with one and push it down with another. You don't have to do that. The minute this, you touch it down to the glue, it lets it go. And if you want to press it down, you just flip it over to this end and push it down. But yeah, don't pay full price for this like I did. I paid full price for this probably 3 years ago. And Michael started carrying it, I would say, sometime last year. But at Michael's, you'll get these two. If you buy them in other places, typically you have to buy them separately. And then I bought the mat that goes with it. Michael's doesn't have the mat. Hi, Maggie. So yeah, Cindy, before you return it, check to make sure your Michael's has it. And then use a coupon. Yeah, I know I have a second one because I misplace this thing all the time too. I'll have it and I close it up and then I put it in a drawer that it's not supposed to go in and then I can't find it. Because yeah, this works great on flat black, flat back rhinestones, and I also use it with the pointing back rhinestones. Because I use bling a lot also when I do metal embellishments. So yeah, like I asked earlier, let me show you the card that people always ask for. Where is it? This is the one that people want me to show them how to make this filigree embellishment here. So if you guys want me to do this one next, for my next live, I can. Or I could do a start to finish. I mean, we can make the whole card. Because this is a card I created in the beginning of this year, and I did 4 different colors, and people fell in love with the red and the blue one that I did. And I only have 2 of them left, because one I gave away for a friend's birthday, and I sold the other one. But yeah, they want to know how to create this one. Okay, so I think I'll try to do it next Saturday. So just this will be a long stream because this takes a long time to dry. The amount of glossy accents that I use on this is ridiculous. So yeah, if you want to make something similar, just be prepared that you need a lot of glossy accents, and you need to give it a lot of time to dry. because I don't like E6000. While it smells wonderful, yes, I love the smell of it, I don't like it when it comes to using this type of stuff. I don't really like to use it. So yeah, I mean, I guess I can plan for next Saturday, and it's probably going to be around noon or 1 Pacific, because I'm on the West Coast. Because yeah, it might be easier to just do it on a live instead of doing a video, that way in case you guys have questions. That's kind of it. And I don't really have anything much more to say. I kind of blabbed a whole bunch already. I don't even know how long I've been on. My phone hasn't died because I have it plugged in. So any other questions? A little party up in here, all kinds of different people. Thanks for stopping by, guys. I wasn't expecting this many people to come on, because usually it's pretty quiet, because I know a lot of times I'm kind of a spur of the moment. I think this is my third live. I kind of just pop on. I don't really give a time, but I'll try for next Saturday around between 12 and 1 Pacific time. But where are the other, did I use the other ones? I sure did. Oh well. Alrighty, I guess that kind of it. I can cut out the video because I've been on for a while. No problem, Dorinda. It's awesome that you stopped by anyway. Yeah, I think that wraps it up. Again, I'll link all of the dyes. If they're still available, I'll link them in the description box. So give me a few minutes after this posts to put up all the links and all that stuff. And then for the cards that I show, I'll link those also in case you want to know the other stuff that I used on it, because I didn't really go over the other stuff that I used on those cards. So I'll link those below. So give it maybe 15, 20 minutes. Sorry, Laurel. Yeah, all I was doing was making flowers. I don't really think anybody wants to keep watching me make flowers. I mean, I can. If you guys want to chat, I can keep making flowers. It's not a problem. But I figured people might be bored by now. Yeah, I do have a whole bunch of flowers to make, so I cut out two birds with one stone. Well, thank you. I tend to like them myself. And I do, I love making flowers. You want me to get a different flower dye? Just because, I mean, like I said, the entire concept is exactly the same. I don't know what other flower dye I could get. I'd have to die cut it. Maybe for another stream. We can make flowers again in another stream. Are any of you guys going to go live today? Because I always forget the notifications. I barely pay attention on the weekends. So if any of you guys are going live, let me know now so I can make sure to look out. Because I think you went live. Didn't you go live on Friday, Laurel, last night? Believe it or not, Cindy, I don't have any rose dyes. There's just, like, to make them look realistic, it's just too much work. So I think that's why I've opted out of roses. I kind of just keep to these other type of dyes. And whatever it looks like is what it looks like. Okay, I will look out for that, Laurel. Try to sneak in. They do take work. I know, like, when I was watching, when Therese was doing her roses, with that punch, the retro punch. They're so pretty. I've made them before, but it's just one of those things where they're tiring. They're pretty. I had those punches and I actually got rid of them because I didn't want to make those roses. Hey girl, how are you? Oh my God, I totally just blanked on your name. That's so bad. And watch, it's gonna come to me later. And I've talked to you enough that I know your name and I can't think of it. There you go, see? Now that you said it, yep. You know you drive me crazy with all of your Tuesday morning videos. Because I don't have a Tuesday morning near me. So I sit there and I watch them and I drool. And I think yours are probably the only Tuesday morning videos that I watch. I avoid Tuesday morning videos from everybody, but I always end up watching yours. Because you do such a little, you take us on a little shopping trip. And you show us everything, you pull it out. I love it. I had thought about getting the Gemini, but I have so many machines already as it is. And I don't like how the plates warp so much on the Gemini, but if it wasn't for the plates, I would probably buy a Gemini. There's one, let's see, because I work like 56 miles from my house. I'd have to go 35 miles in the opposite direction of me going home in order to get to one. And that's the only one nearby, so I tend to never go to Tuesday morning. Usually, if I get something from Tuesday morning, it's my friend Julie that goes. She goes to her Tuesday morning and sends it to me. Because it's just not convenient. Yeah, I have the eBosser, which is what they renamed, which is now the Cut and Boss. I have that. It works for me, so I haven't had the need to buy another electronic machine. But if my eBosser ever craps out, I might give in and get Gemini. But, I mean, I've had my eBosser because I've had it since they first came out. I would say actively cutting on it. I've been actively cutting on my eBosser probably for the last 2 years. And I'm still on the same plate. It has not warped. And, I mean, this is what my plate looks like. It has a crack right here on both sides, but as you can see, it is still flat. And I've been cutting on this for 2 years, and I cut constantly, constantly. I mean, that plate has gone through my machine thousands and thousands of times, and it has not warped, it has not broken. I do have like two backup plates, but I haven't needed to use them, and I don't think I'll need to use them for a while. Yeah, they do have good deals on the Gemini. I've seen it, but again, I'm not a huge fan of Crafter Companion dies. They just don't, I don't know what it is, but I'm not drawn to them. The same thing, like I'm not drawn to Tattered Lace. I'm not drawn to, what are the other companies? And while some of the dyes are very pretty, I'm just not drawn to them. They don't really do it for me. I need more glue. Yes, rehab would be nice. I have so many machines. And because I have so many, I do put them on rotation. I do use them. I don't have that old school one. My original version 1 Cuddlebug did die about 2 years ago. I you know the handle that you grip? I broke the plastic casing that had it on it. So it was just the metal rod. And every time I crank it, it would come back on me and I'd cut my hands. Like, I remember I used to cut this area of my hand and the gashes would be so deep that I just ended up getting rid of it. Because, I mean, it would bleed for a long time. I'm like, yeah, no. I love crafting, but not enough to get that injured over it. So I got rid of it. But, I mean, I have the Grand Caliber, the original one. I have this Platinum 6, which I love the Platinum 6. I actually would want the big Platinum, but I use the Big Shot Plus. So I just haven't gotten around to buying the original Platinum. I have my eBosser. I have the Big Shot Pro. I mean, I have enough machines. I don't really need any more. But yeah, the only one that I've gone onto multiple plates is the Big Shot. That one I have had to use. I am on a couple of plates now. But everything else, I still have the original ones and I've used them a lot. Looks a little lopsided, but oh well. I'm so surprised my kids are quiet. I think I've been on a while. Nope, don't put it on that one. So who's gonna make flowers? Art glitter glue. I either use the art glitter glue or I use the Nouveau. Either or. I agree. It's quiet does equal scary, but my boys are a little bit older. My oldest just turned 12 and my little one is 7. He'll be 8 in October. So at least quiet means they're not fighting. But I do hear the PS4 on and I hear YouTube on. So as long as I hear those, we're good. Go make some flowers, Cindy. The large flowers are nice. While, like, I bought some of the David Tatera ones, the big Sizzix ones. I don't like the way they turn out. I bought the ones that will make the big 12 by 12 flowers. And I didn't do a video on them because I tried them out. I didn't like it, so I took it back to the store. But yeah, you definitely got to make sure that when you're making large flowers like that for decor, you definitely want to use really thick cardstock. Like this one, I mean, I started tearing this one apart, but this one's a good size. This is the other Sizzix one. I haven't used it since I made it. Like you see, I tore out the center of it, but this is a good size. And that's probably the largest of his flowers that I'll use. And that is, where is it? That's this one. And I don't really like it. The flower is very pretty, but I don't like the way you have to assemble it. And I did do a die feature on that one, and yeah, to me it's a pain in the butt. For this one, you definitely want to try to use hot glue. But what time is it? Ooh, it's almost 3 o'clock. I should get off. But yeah, that's one of David Tatera's smaller flowers, and the way you make them, I don't like. The big ones, same thing. Blech. I don't like the tool, like that curling tool. I think it's garbage. But yeah, I don't like any of it. Hey, Ebony. I know you love the flowers. You use them. I love seeing them. Every time I see a project, I'm wondering, am I going to see a flower that I sent you? But that's still awesome to see. Because usually, like me, I'm a perfect example of that. Where if I swap with someone, I don't like to use any of the stuff that's sent to me. I keep it and I display it. So yeah, if I swap with you and you send me something, 99 to 100% chances I will never use it. It'll go on display. So I like the fact that you actually use them. That the white set was pack number 4, because I think I sent you 3 in the loaded envelope, and then I sent you that white one separately. Have you used all of them already? Because, yeah, I sent Ebony 4 packs of this style right here. And she's put them on all of her projects. Wait, I did send her, I think I sent her some of these ones too. Yeah, I sent her some of these Cherry Lynn ones too. You've only used one, so you're hoarding now. You're hoarding them. Ooh, too much glue. Shantae, you gonna make some flowers? Oh wait, is that one too big? I think that one's too big. Yeah, no, that one's too big. I don't want that one there. Just kidding. Ooh, let's put it on this guy then. Look, and I said I was gonna get off, and I haven't gotten off yet. Ah! I just got it stuck. And I stabbed myself. Oh yeah, if you get these tweezers, be careful. They're sharp. They're super sharp. Like, the point on this, like, I don't know how many times I've stabbed myself, and I've had to wear band-aids because I start bleeding everywhere. But yeah, especially if you have them around little ones, it does come with them. Oh, I don't have any with the cover. They do come with the plastic cover to go over them. So if you have your little ones around and you have these, make sure you keep your cover. I keep these up high out of reach, so even my 7-year-old can't grab them. Because he grabbed them once wondering what it was, and he touched the end and he poked himself. Yeah, the Nouveau Glue is on sale. It's been on sale for weeks. Oh, you know what? While I'm sitting here, I should make the white ones at least. While we chat. I guess there's no longer need for tutorial. But I do gotta make a bunch of these, so. If we chat for a little while longer. I know I want to buy more bottles, but like I said, I'm on a spending freeze for a while, so no more for me for a bit. So Shantae, did you go and actually look at the new Kaleidoscope release? Like I told you, I'm going on a tonic strike. I will not be buying anything of theirs for a while. And again, for those of you that are late, this is an SVG file from the Silhouette store, not a dye. So again, I'll have that the item number in the description box too. So yeah, I'll stay on for maybe another 10 minutes maybe. Get some of these flowers done, and then I'll get off. Because yeah, I think I've been on for, how long have I been on, Shantae? I don't remember. I know it's been at least an hour. I mean, I don't really think you really have to look at it. I did watch it. I wasn't going to, but I did watch it. The designs on the panel are pretty, to me, they're mediocre. They're not, I'm not a huge fan of their designs anyway, as far as when it comes to those decorative dies. But unless there's a panel that is a different height from the four that they have, I won't buy any of them. And for the triangle lid, it's gonna be a relatively small triangle. I only want it just for the mere fact that it's a new lid. So I'll buy it, but I'm not in a rush to get it. Ooh, it's been almost 2 hours already. Oh my God. I guess time flies when you're having fun. So yeah, just a few more minutes and then I'll get off. Because I'm sure my kids will want to eat soon. I fed them before I came on stream, so to make sure they didn't really bother me. But yeah, that's kind of about it. Not really much more going on. Actually, we can glue two down at a time. It does fly when you're crafting. And I haven't crafted in a while. I didn't craft at all last weekend. So it's been about, yeah, it's been about 2 weeks, I think. Ah, I need to bring this down so I can look at it. Because if not, I won't center it. I didn't realize I set the camera so far so far back. Yeah, I didn't think you'd be interested in it. But yeah, the lid, I'll get it just for the mere fact that I'm collecting the kaleidoscope range. But I don't think I'll get the panels at all. They're kind of ugly. And sorry, I keep pulling the flower out of frame because I'm trying to center it and I don't want to stand up to look at it. Yeah, I was gonna get off and then people started chatting. So I figured I'd chat just a few more minutes, but I am about to get off in a little bit because I have been on for almost 2 hours. So I guess I gotta make the flowers either way, so I might as well chat while we're at it. It'll probably take me about 2 weeks to make all of those flowers, though. So I might as well knock some out. I mean, and also I will make them a lot faster while I'm not talking. But yeah, just kind of finishing up. It's getting hot in here. I gotta turn on my AC. I think it's in the hundreds again today. What are all these messages I'm getting? What's your name, Crafty Grandma? I forgot. I think you might have said it before. So I know I've seen you in another life, and I can't remember your name. Can you tell me what your name is, please? But yeah, they really aren't hard. There really is not much to it. Just pick out a die that Joanne. Thank you. Just pick out a die that you really like, and like I said, all I do is cup the flowers up. Everything else is too technical, too time-consuming. And it really pushes a lot of people away from wanting to make their own flowers because it is complicated. I have all of those stylus tools. I've made flowers with them, but I don't like it. I don't like them at all. So yeah, that's one of the reasons why I did the live is everyone always asks, how do you make your flowers? How do you make your flowers? And they think it's really difficult, but it's not. So yeah, you find dies, punches, flower punches is the same thing. Just make sure when you're doing it, have at least two different sizes, because you always want to have offsetting. You want the two different sizes to give you a different look to it. Gives you more dimension, more depth than if you just use one size. But yeah, punches work. SVG files work. Yeah, super easy. Again, a lot of us, you know, I work full time. I have two kids. I don't have time to sit there and spend hour, you know, 20, 30 minutes on a flower. While they're gorgeous, exactly, roses are difficult. While those flowers are super gorgeous and awesome, I don't have time for any of that. If I had the luxury of being able to craft for long periods of time and not just on the weekends, I probably would take more time to create more realistic looking flowers. But I'm okay with these kind. They're quick, easy, and as you do them more, you'll put these together so fast, you won't even, by the time you're done, you're going to be like, oh my God, I made so many flowers. I do. That's what I'm actually making these for. I have a large order of flowers that I need to make. But I do. I don't have a store. I used to, but stores are time consuming. It's kind of like more of a, if you ask me, I'll make them and I'll sell them. But it's not like I'll make them and just be like, oh, these are for sale. It's not really my thing. I've been asked to do it, to put it up in a store, and I've considered doing a store and throwing flowers in there, but, I mean, flowers is something that you can make yourself, so it's not really something that I would be like, oh, I'm going to throw a whole bunch up, because they are easy. I feel kind of bad when I sell them to people, because you can make them yourself. So yeah, get out your punches, any flower dies, if you have an electronic cutter. There's lots of different flowers. Like I did get a new poinsettia from the Silhouette store, and I actually will do a video on that one because it's a similar shape to this one, except it has six petals, and they have some other designs within it, so I'm going to go ahead and make that one and see how it looks. I agree, Ebony. It is nice to just have it in a pack all ready to go. It is ideal. And so I understand why people want to buy them, but, you know, it's just one of those things where I just hesitate with it. I do it, but I don't advertise it. Because majority of the stuff that I do is kind of like, it's customers that I've had for years, years, and years that I've hooked up with through craft fairs. Because I used to do craft fairs. Yeah, I can see that too. Hi, Leticia. Thank you. You jumped on right at the end. I'm about to get off in a few minutes because I've been on for almost 2 hours. So yeah, that poinsettia that I was telling you guys that I bought from the Silhouette store, I actually am excited to try that one out. I'll cut it out this weekend and I'll try to get a video tomorrow. I can't promise it. Yeah, I'll try. But I was trying to do a project because I haven't done a project in a while. And then people want me to do a dye feature series on the tonic, what was that one? I bought it from Blitzy. I just forgot what the name of the dye was. The Cathedral Box. I've been asked for that one for, I would say at least 4 or 5 months, I've had several people asking me to do a dye feature on that one, and I have it now. So I gotta get to it, I guess. Yeah, it's a long video, with DC. I've been on for like 2 hours, and most of the stuff I cover in the very beginning. So no need to sit for 2 hours and listen to the rambling. If you want to, by all means, go ahead, but, you know. But yeah, all you need is glue, a flower of your choice. This is my tool, a tweet set of tweezers. That's it. No shaping tools, no foam mat, none of that stuff. If you don't have long nails like I do, you probably can get away without using tweezers, because all I do is cut the flowers. I use tweezers because my nails. I can craft with them, but of course when it comes to detail stuff, they do get in the way because they are long, so tweezers are a lifesaver. I can't believe you guys have sat here for almost two hours just watching me make flowers. I mean, granted, I know people have popped in and out, but it's been a pretty consistent number. I use heavyweight cardstock. I won't use lightweight. 65-pound cardstock, when it comes to these flowers, while you can make them, they don't hold their shape very well. The heavier the cardstock, the more they'll hold their shape because they're stiff. They stay relatively stiff. Like the white is Recollections 110-pound, and the red is Pop Tone 100-pound. Oh my God, Shelly, you're still here? I can't believe you're still here. You put off your cleaning? Are you at least, what are you crafting, ATCs? And again, too, I don't wet my cardstock. That's something that a lot of flower makers do, is they wet their cardstock when they're making flowers. I don't. I like the paper stiff. And I also don't like waiting for the flowers to dry. So that's another reason why I don't wet them. So yeah, that's the only difference to mine. Is I don't wet my flowers at all, ever. If I wet them, it's because it's finished and I'm like spraying them with like a shimmer spray. And on certain things, like I am going to do, this is a project I've been talking about probably for the last 2 years or so. I did a cardstock canvas. All of it was die cutting. All of it was like flowers, greenery. It was a 5x7 canvas, and I double layered every single die cut that I put on there. I cut it all out of Recollections 110-pound. I actually used, where is it? The Cherry Lynn, the Judy's Blue. I moved all the dies to the side and I used this die, the one that I was talking about earlier. And a whole bunch of other Cherry Lynn dyes, and it's all die cuts. And I'm gonna make myself a large 12x12, but that one of course takes a lot of die cutting, and I just haven't gotten around to it. So I don't know, I might do a start to finish on it. Not a live, but a start to finish. I mean, it's possible if you guys want a live, I can do it live, but it'll definitely be a couple of sessions. But yeah, I love it. I loved it so much and I had to give it away. And I've been wanting to make another one. I have a memory box that I need to send, memory decks that I need to send out to Judy. She had her challenge, and I got so busy with other stuff that I didn't get it mailed in by the end of her birthday challenge. So I still have to send it in to her. It's here. I just need to get to it. I've never made one either. That was my first time making one as well. Alrighty. So yeah, I guess, yeah, it's 10 minutes. I guess I'll cut this off and end the stream. But yeah, this is the same flour I was making earlier. It's this one, so it's not like it's a new flour. Well, that's nice that you're new to crafting. Just remember, don't get overwhelmed with your crafting. And you gotta craft and make it fun for you. And don't worry about what anybody else thinks, because it doesn't matter how long you've been around, people are gonna talk negative, because there's just negative people out there. So yeah. So make some flowers, and yeah, I'll try to do the stream for that embellishment next Saturday. All right? So thank you guys so much for stopping by. A lot more people turned up than I was expecting, so thank you. And again, if you guys have any questions, let me know. And I'll list all of the dies, the SVG files, and the links to the other cards in the description box. So give me like a good 20 minutes, and I'll have everything linked below. Okay? All right, guys. I'll talk to you guys later. Shelly, I'm going to go hit you up on Facebook, so... And same thing with you, Shantae, if you're still around. You know we're never done talking. So yeah, I'll hit you guys up in a little bit. Alright, again. Thanks. Bye, guys. Okay, now. Climb up on my chair to end the live. And where is the stop? Oh, shoot. Where is it? Wait, right here? Nope. Cancel. Oh, no. I'll do it from my computer. Easier to do it from the computer. Bye, Lasagna. All right, go to this YouTube over here. So yeah, I'm gonna be chattering while I go and end it, because a lot of times it gets annoying to end it from my phone without shaking it too much. So I gotta end the stream from the computer. And customize. And you get to listen to my sound effects while I do it. Because I like sound effects. Live streaming. And events. And edit. And end. Where's my end? Son of a biscuit. Hold on. Stop streaming. There it is.